Very good morning. In today's topic, we'll discuss regarding the disease condition cancer. Coming to the cancer here, what is the definition of this cancer? Means cancer is an abnormal growth of cells which is having the ability to involve the adjacent tissues and even the distant organs and eventually leading to the death of the affected patients. So if the tumor has progressed to the stage where it cannot be treated, so what is the definition here? So if you see the definition, it is nothing but it is an abnormal growth in the tissue cells which is leading, which is involving even the adjacent structures and even the adjacent organs, which is uncontrollably growing, and it is ultimately leading to the death of the person if he is left untreated. So cancer, if you see, it is mainly categorized, means it is regarded as a group of diseases that are characterized by abnormal growth of cells. So these are mainly characterized based on the ability to invade the adjacent structures and tissues, which are eventually causing the death of the patient. So if you see here, if the tumor is going to the stages, if you see the cancer stages, we have like 4 stages. So at stage 1, that cancer tissue is pertaining to the cell itself. In stage 2, it will be enlarging. In stage 3, it will be involving the adjacent structures. In stage 4, it is going all over the body, means it is reaching the even other systems also. So in the same way here, if you are able to treat the person at stage 1 or even at stage 2, if you are able to successfully remove the tumor, you can save the patient. So coming to the incidence here, so if you see, cancer, it is responsible for about 12% of the deaths that are occurring globally. It is responsible for about the deaths that were occurring about 10% globally here. And if you see, it is the third most cause of the deaths, that is accounting for 9.5% around the all deaths that are occurring in the world. So cancer, it is responsible for 12% of the deaths that are occurring, and it is the third most common disease. So it is accounting for 9.5% of all deaths that are occurring. So according to the GlobeCan, that is WHO, there are more than 12.7 million persons that are diagnosed with the disease cancer during the year 2008. And if you see, in these diagnosed cases, in these 12.7 million persons that were diagnosed in the year 2008, in this 12.7 million persons, there were about 12.7% of lung cancers deaths that are occurring annually, and breast cancer, it is accounting for 10.9% of total deaths which were occurring because of the disease cancer. And colorectal cancer, means colon and rectal cancer, it is accounting for 9.8% of all cancers deaths that were occurring annually. So coming to the India, if you see the prevalence rate in India, it is about 2 to 2.5 million cases in the year 2008, and we have new cases like 9.4 lakh cases per every year, that is like 4.3 lakhs males and 5.1 females. So if you see here with these numbers, we can see that the females are getting more affected compared to the males. So cancer deaths that had occurred here are about 6.3 lakhs. In those 6.3 lakhs, the deaths were about 3.21 lakh deaths in the males and 3.12 lakhs in the females. And incidence rate is about 98.5 per lakh population. And mortality rate is 68 lakhs per population. So what are the epidemiological factors that are involved in the disease cancer? So if you see the agent factor, firstly we will discuss there are several types of agent factors. Firstly, we'll discuss what is this nutritional agent factor. So whenever a person is consuming high fat diet, it is mainly causing the breast and colon cancer. And high fiber diet, it is causing the intestinal cancer. And smoked fish to this, If a person is taking the food such as smoked fish, it is causing the stomach cancer. And beef consumption, it is mainly leading to the bowel cancer. And alcohol, it can cause the esophageal and liver cancer. So what are the cancers which were related to the nutrition? If a person is taking the high fat diet, it is leading to the breast and colon cancer. If anybody is taking the high fiber diet, it is leading to the intestinal cancer. And if some persons are consuming the smoked fish, it is causing the stomach cancer. And the persons who eat the beef, so there it is causing the bowel cancer. And alcohol, it can cause the esophageal as well as liver cancers. So coming to the chemical, So what are the chemical factors? We have seen regarding the nutritional factors, agent factors, and now we'll see chemical agent factors. So when a person is exposed to certain types of chemicals such as arsenic and cadmium, chromium, asbestos, aniline and benzol and coal tar, these are mainly causing the cancers involving various sites or various organs. So the persons who are exposed to these type of chemicals like arsenic, cadmium, chromium and asbestos, aniline and benzol and coal tar, these persons are having more risk for getting the cancer. Next thing is tobacco. So the persons who consume tobacco, so persons who are smoking and betel nut chewing, means persons who chew the tobacco, these persons are more prone to get lung, pharynx, mouth, esophagus, bladder and pancreas, and probably sometimes even the kidney cancer is also common in the persons who are taking the tobacco. So the more the person is consuming the tobacco or smoking, so based on the organ, we are having these cancers like lung, pharynx, we have mouth cancer, esophageal cancers, bladder cancers, pancreas, and sometimes even the kidney also it will cause. Coming to the biological factors here, so we have viruses like hepatitis B and hepatitis C. These viruses are related to the hepatocellular carcinoma, and HIV infection, it is one of the risk factor for Kupffer's sarcoma, and the human papilloma virus, it is mostly responsible for the cancer of the cervix. So the females who are having this cervical cancer, these females are mostly affected with this human papilloma virus. Coming to the parasites here, so parasites such as schistosomiasis, so these are mainly occurring in the Middle East. These people are associated with having the risk of bladder cancer. And next one is physical factors. So the persons who are exposed to the sunlight and the ionizing radiation, these are one of the major causes which are leading to the cancer, such as basal cell carcinoma and oral carcinoma and leukemia. So these are some of the physical factors which are involving. So coming to the host factors, so if you see, males are more often affected than females, expected for cancers of reproductive organs. So, and age factors here, elderly people are often affected than the younger age groups. And if you see, some cancers are occurring because of bimodal occurrence, like Hodgkin's disease, kidney cancer and leukemia, which are common in young adults and elderly persons. So this is related to the age factor. In age, mostly elder persons are affected compared to the younger groups. Coming to the habits, so the persons who are eating the paan, the persons who are eating the jadap, the persons who are consuming the tobacco, these persons are having more risk for occurring the oropharyngeal cancer. And excessive sex with multiple partners, they are having the chances for cervical cancer. And smoking and alcoholism, it is mainly associated with the lung cancer and poor personal hygiene. So when a female, they are having the poor personal hygiene, there are more chances for the occurrence of cervical cancer. So coming to the genetic factors, so genetic factors where the translocation of chromosomes are found, so there you can observe the cancer conditions such as myeloid leukemia. So we can observe the blood cancers, and Mongols are more likely to develop the cancer than the normal children. And a defective gene present in the long arm of the chromosomes, that is 13, predisposes to familial retinoblastoma. So it may cause the retinoblastoma where the long arm chromosomes are defective. And next thing is, there is a familial tendency in the occurrence of the breast cancer. So the persons who are having this defective gene, long arm of the chromosome 13 predisposes, these are mainly affected with this retinoblastoma, and also they are having the occurrence of for the tendency of breast cancer. So what are the environmental factors which are favoring this cancer, means, so where there are hydrocarbons emitted by the automobiles, so these are some of the predisposing factors for the causes of lung cancer. And overuse of estrogen, it may lead to the cancer of the body of the uterus. So when a female, they are consuming the when they are using excessive estrogen, it may lead to the cancer of the uterus. So how you can prevent and control the cancer, means, so there we have primordial prevention. So in primordial prevention, we are mainly concentrating on the modification and elimination of risk factors among the population who are having chances to develop. So people, these people are made aware of protecting themselves from the carcinogenic exposures and even the danger signs of this cancer by health education mainly. So by creating awareness regarding the warning signs of the cancer of the cervix, such as bleeding after the menopause or bleeding in between the menstrual period. So young girls in particular and women in general, they are taught regarding the menstrual and genital hygiene for the prevention of cervical cancer. So next thing is educating the children and adolescents to develop healthy habits and lifestyle, and educating them about the hazards of smoking and the hazards which were related to the alcohol, and teaching them the healthy habits such as doing exercise and the healthy diet and personal hygiene. So these are the some factors which are preventing the cancers in the children. Parents and teachers, they should be a role model for the children in the family as well as in the colleges, mainly in doing the exercises, in following the healthy diet and in following the personal hygiene. As the children are absorbing the parents and teachers and they are learning, if you are able to project ourselves in a right manner to the children, then automatically the healthy habits will be habituated by the children and the health hazards can be prevented. And we should focus tobacco free society, and it should be aimed at the schools and colleges, because the adults and the teen, the younger children, these are the ones who are more attracted toward the tobacco as well as the alcohol. So if you are able to give proper health education to these type of people, if you are able to create an awareness in these children, we can promote the health as well as we can prevent the diseases such as cancers. So nurses can teach the following to the high risk group. So mainly we have to educate them to quit the tobacco, smoking as well as chewing, and we should restrict them to take the alcohol. Though if you are able to educate them in a good manner to restrict the alcohol, so the cancers can be prevented, and to have only one faithful married partner. So instead of having multiple sex partners, the girls or the women, they should be faithful to the married partner in their sexual life, so that these diseases like cervical cancer and uterine cancers can be prevented. And next thing is family history as well as breast cancer. So the persons who are having the family history of this breast cancer, so they should be mainly using the warning signs. If you see the warning signs, we have the warning such as caution. So what is this caution means? If you see this caution, you can observe the changes that were present in the bowel and bladder, and you can observe the ulcers that does not heal properly, and you can feel unusual bleeding or even the discharge from the cervix or the vagina, and you can observe the cervical thickening which is present in the breast. Even you can observe the thickening of the breast and even in the other parts of the body where the lump is forming, and you can observe the indigestion or difficulty in swallowing whenever you are taking food, whenever there is more chances for having the oral cancer. And there will be like a change in the body pattern. You can observe lots of moles and rats which are appearing at a sudden, and even you can see the nagging cough or even the hoarseness of voice. So what is this? We have the symptoms such as caution, CAUTION. So if you see, it is mainly dealing with the bowel and bladder. You can observe the changes that are there in the bowel and bladder. You can see unhealing ulcers, and there are unusual discharge from the cervix during the menstrual period. So it can occur during the menstrual period, or even it can occur after the menstrual period was over. And this T is standing for the thickness which is there in the lump or any part of the body where the lump is starting to forming. And the next one is I. This I is standing for indigestion. So where there is indigestion and where there is difficulty in swallowing. And O is, it is mainly focusing on the body. You can observe moles, newly formed moles, and rats. You can observe the rats. Next thing is, and this N is standing for the nagging cough. You can observe the nagging cough or the hoarseness of the voice in the persons who are having this cancer signs. So women should be they should have the marriage at an appropriate age. So they should practice the personal hygiene and perineal hygiene, and women should have the pap smear test for every 6 months to screen for the cervical cancer. And so individuals who are at risk, who are at above risk factor, they should be referred for screening for cancer every time. So next thing is population strategy. So in this population strategy, cancer education is given to the general public. So as we have discussed, so all the warning signs of the cancer are taught to the person. So as I said, there will caution will come into the play here. So lump in the breast, non-healing ulcers, and change in mole or vrat. You can have persistent cough. There will be lump in the testicles. You can have the unexplained loss of weight, and there will be difficulty in chewing and swallowing. So these are some of the warning signs that can be taught to the population. So that whenever a person is experiencing these types of signs and symptoms, they can go for the screening and they can have the appropriate diagnosis. Next one is health education. So the health education is mainly given to the people regarding the personal hygiene and genital hygiene. And a regular exercise will decrease the risk of obesity and early menarche. And next one is BSE. Mainly, if you see, they are encouraging the women to perform BSE every month. So BSE means nothing but breast self examination. Breast self examination. So whenever a woman, they are performing the breast self examination every month, so it should be performed after a week of menstruation. Whenever she had a menstruation, if she is performing the breast self-examination, and women after the menopause, they should perform this breast self-examination every month, so that when there is any kind of lump or any thickening mass which is present in the breast, it can be observed early, and if it is possible, it can be removed and it can be diagnosed in a good manner. Next thing is testicular self-examination. This testicular self-examination, it should be performed by the men regularly to detect any kind of lumps in the testis. So if they are finding any kind of lumps, they can go to the doctor, they can have proper screening, and the disease can be prevented even before it is occurring. Next thing is avoiding exposure to the radiation. So special effort should be made to reduce the radiation amount that should be received by each individual. So they have to wear the protection while they are going for any radiation. Next thing is health education. So what is this health education? In this, we are explaining them regarding the use of vegetables at least 500 grams per day, and legumes and whole grains and cereals, and you should avoid the foods such as junk foods, and avoid the coloring agents, and fatty foods which are causing the obesity, they should be avoided to prevent the breast cancer. So if you are following these dietary habits, these healthy habits, we can control the cancer. We should eat the vegetables and legumes and whole grains and cereals, and we should avoid foods such as junk foods and coloring agents, and what are all the fatty foods are there, they should be avoided to prevent the breast cancer. Next one is treatment of precancerous lesions. So whenever we are able to perform the self-examinations, if you are having any precancerous lesions such as cervical TS or intestinal polyps or VRATs or chronic gastritis or chronic cervicitis, so all these can be treated early whenever we are detecting them early. Next thing is specific protection. So any person, the X-ray technicians who are working in the X-ray labs, the persons who are always exposed to the radiation, these persons should wear a protective devices mainly to prevent the harmful radiations to enter into the body, and they should have an exam. They should have a monthly or 2 monthly exam to find out any kind of abnormality which is noted in the body. And industrial workers who are working, they should wear an apron which is made of lead, and they should use the gloves and even the respirators. And if you want to prevent specific type of cancers, there are specific cancer vaccines that were available, and these cancer vaccines are either intended to treat the existing cancer or even to prevent the development of the cancer. So this is regarding the specific protection. So what are the legislative measures that has been taken place to prevent means? So Government of India, it has passed an act that cigarettes, so regulation of the production and supply and distribution. It should be done in the surveillance manner. So in 1975, all states of all the persons trading in cigarette have to display the warning sign. So if you see here, whenever you are going in the movie theaters, or even you can see on the cigarette pack itself, even you can see it on the gutka packet itself, that smoking cigarette causes cancer and chewing tobacco causes cancer and drinking alcohol, it causes cancer. You can see on the labels itself that it was printed there. So it was the act which was made in the year 1975 that all the persons who are trading the cigarette, they have to display this warning sign on the products. And legislative council is for also for controlling the air pollutions, and they are mainly aiming to prevent the lung cancer. So if you are able to reduce the industrialized waste that is being released into the air, if you are able to prevent this air pollution, then easily you can reduce the lung cancer. Next thing is, so the persons who are working, the persons who are having risk for the occurrence of cancer, who are having exposure to the radiation, these are enacted in the Indian Factories at the Act of 1948. So according to the Act 1948, the persons who are having this occupational hazard, who are having the risk for the cancer, they are mainly included in the employee state insurance scheme, that is in the year 1948. So next one is secondary prevention. So in this secondary prevention, mainly they are going for the registration, cancer registration, so that we can plan and implement the required services. So we have hospital based registries here. So whoever, it is including all the outpatients as well as the inpatients, so who are taking the treatment in the hospital, and it should be done as per the WHO handbook, that is standardized for cancer registries. So firstly we are going for the early detection of cases. So mainly we can achieve this by cancer screening, and what is the stage of the cancer, so that we can localize, so we can give the treatment. So the treatment is including surgery, sometimes chemotherapy, radiotherapy and immunotherapy. So these are some of the treatment modalities which were used. So if it is in the stage 1, and if the surgeon or the doctor feels to remove, it can be removed so that we can go for the surgery. And if it is going to the adjacent structures, then they might go for the chemotherapy. Sometimes they might go for chemotherapy, radiotherapy as well as surgery also. Next one is territory prevention. So in this territory prevention, it is aiming at the disability limitation and rehabilitation. Mainly they want to decrease the disability which is caused due to the cancer, which is caused due to any kind of surgery, and they are mainly focusing on the rehabilitation. Next one is disability limitation. So what is this disability limitation? So this is done by intensive treatment to prevent the development of disability in the patient. Mainly the disability due to pain, disability due to vitality, disability due to loss of weight, disability due to lot of fatigue and discomfort, and that is occurring in the advanced stages. So they are focusing on the disability limitation. What is this rehabilitation means? As I said, the persons who are undergoing the surgery, so once the leg is amputated, so we can give them prosthesis. So prosthesis means nothing but artificial limbs or legs can be given to these type of persons, and physiotherapy is given mainly to train this person to walk with those artificial limbs. Next thing is rehabilitation. So mainly it is focusing on the psychological problem of the patient, as well as it is focusing on the social, spiritual and family problems. So with this, I would like to conclude the session. So if you like the content, please like, share and subscribe the channel, and if you have any queries, you can drop them in the comment box. Thank you. Thanks for watching.